Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I'm going to share with you all about five must have books for each and every graduate, homeopathic graduate, to understand materia medica in the best possible way. You know, what are those top five books? So the first book I'll be recommending is Materia Medica by William Borick, Borick's Materia Medica to be precise and to keep it simple, because this is one of those books which will make us understand that the pathological aspect and the physiology involved in each and every remedy, and makes it very clear in what kind of diseases presented to us we can think of the concern or say the specific remedy. There is no some kind of confusion going on. It's really, really cut to the point, and it's really, really must have book for each and every graduate. And the second book I'll be recommending is Allen's Keynotes. The Allen's Keynotes is really, really a very, very must have important book for everyone, because it is really, really, really easy to go through the book. It summarizes the important aspects in each and every remedy. So what we learn in Borick, that will be cut short and that will be put to very easy points in Allen's Keynotes. So this is the way I would suggest: if you want to understand a remedy, first go through that remedy in Borick, then followed by Allen's Keynotes, then you will understand properly. Otherwise, if you first of all open Allen's Keynotes, the more what we will be expecting is only to memorize symptoms. You don't have a clear understanding what actually the remedy is. To avoid that confusion, you have to, it's my opinion, it helped me basically. Opinions differ, however. So for me, referring Borick first followed by Allen's Keynotes really, really helped me in understanding remedies in the best possible way. And the third book obviously is Kent's Materia Medica lectures, actually. So it's not as such a Materia Medica, it is a compilation of the lectures given by Dr. J.T. Kent. So I'll definitely advise you to don't jump into this book from the first day itself, because nothing is going to get into your head. So this is the way I will proceed generally: B.A.K., Borick, Allen's, and then Kent. Because Borick gives you an idea of what a remedy can do, and Allen's will make you understand what exactly the characteristics of that remedy, and Kent gives you the different scenarios from the mouth of a really, really renowned physician who used those remedies. So it will give us a clinical experience. So in this way, if you proceed, it will definitely help you understanding MM in the best possible way. And the fourth book I'll be recommending is Nash, Therapeutic Leaders by Nash, which is one of my favorite book. I've been carrying it around since the very first day of my BHMS. I still remember that. It's a really, really small book, but it has a lot of information. Nash is one of those physicians who is like no nonsense kind of physician. He just tells about the points and the remedies which really helped him in getting any kind of response or say results. If you don't get any kind of result, will just mention it off clearly: I didn't find this remedy useful at all in my clinical experience. So it is just an experience of really, really very much a very great homeopathic physician, and you feel as if you're interacting with the person whenever you study Nash. Nash is one of my favorite books. If I want to list it out, Nash and Borick are really a must go for me, but this is one of the book I'll definitely recommend you to have. And the fifth book I'll be recommending you all guys, though I didn't have it in my undergraduate, I still feel very much guilt about this, because I didn't refer to it in my BHMS. I think if I referred it back then, I'm sure I would have had a better understanding of MM, and that is Clinical Materia Medica by E.A. Farrington. Is a very, very great book. It's like compilation of the remedies. What are the commonalities between the remedies? Why do some characteristics are seen only in one group of remedies? Why are they not seen in another group of remedies? All such stuff is really systematically and very thoroughly arranged in this book, and it's definitely a must-have book for everyone. So these are my five favorite books and must-have books I would be recommending for someone who want to have a very good understanding of Materia Medica in their UG level or BHMS level. So if you like this video, don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to this channel for such more some senior to junior talks and some really friendly suggestions regarding how to study and how to understand homeopathy in a much better way. So don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Till then, bye bye and have a good day. Bye.